go.
It's gonna come down to procs here, but I think if I was Raigeki, he does have first pick. There's gonna be a balance between does he want that Hathor first? Does he think he's gonna get that Hathor? And does he just wanna take an LD unit out of Treeside?
We'll see. There's the Nephthys getting pre-banned by Raigeki. Ganymede getting pre-banned by a tree.
So this tells me that Tree is very content to let Raigeki take that Hathor first pick. Raigeki is likely gonna take that Hathor. You're gonna see an Illyana or some sort of a Fran from Treeside.
Ooh, Fran coming from Raigeki. I think he's done his homework on Tree, but Tree responding with the Hathor himself and the Molly.
Interesting choice to take the Molly so early. I would really be surprised if Raigeki did not take a Sierra here. So he does take that Sierra as predicted, and Oberon damage off the bat does not care about the glancing from Molly.
Yep, that's right. Well, Raigeki is hoping to pummel through Tree's defenses as Tree's going to be drafting a Chibu, maybe a Beast Rider coming after him.
I don't think we're going to see. Oh, we do see a Beast Rider. Okay. We were not expecting that. I would like to see Raigeki take an Okeanos here, and I would almost be surprised. I would be surprised if we did not see an Okeanos. Right now, it looks like Chibu is the tentative ban just because it puts Tree's comp into a commanding position, where if he's able to go off, there's that Hathor, there's that Savannah that's able to go off.
Yep, we've got two more picks coming from Raigeki, showing the Juno right now, and one more unit, a Mia Ying. Raigeki showing he's got LD Nat 5s as well. We see a Mia Ying.
Mia Ying tells me he is not taking out the Molly here. Raigeki is also likely not going to, actually probably pretty content to ban out that fifth unit, but if he does so, he's going to lose that Oberon early. So we'll see what he goes with, but I really like that Juno pick here. Juno pick very solid into whatever Tree's presenting because Tree cannot do enough burst damage onto Juno.
Yep, well, Raigeki has a very aggressive draft. Tree responding with Ada. I don't know if that's going to be enough. There's defense breaks, there's ignore defense here, there's bombs. There's a lot of things prepared for this Ada.
Yeah, and if he's taking the Arda here, he's telling us he's either banning Mi Ying or planning to control it for the entire match, which I'm not sure if that's possible to control this Mi Ying given the fact that there's a Fran here. Chooses not to, takes out the Oberon instead.
Oberon getting banned out here, and then we have Chibu getting banned on Tree's side of the field. Well, all right, guys, we're going in. We've got round one with Tree and Raigeki. Let's get into it.
All right, so we see that Raigeki's Fran's actually outspeeding Tree's entire team here.
Yep, outspeeding for sure. Savannah looking to pummel in some damage on the Ciara's unit of choice.
And at the same time here, this Mi Ying resists that sleep, which is giant here.
Huge resist, but Ciara's looking to plant a bomb. Nobody has immunity. Bomb gets resisted on top of Savannah, cycling a little bit of attack bar, gaining another additional turn, cycling more attack bar, and Ada pummeling a lot of damage in on top of Ciara.
And again, Tree doesn't have an attack, a defense breaker coming up soon. You see that Ciara's moving in front of that Savannah, so at the same time, Raigeki's going to be able to pick this Ciara up. There's a lot of damage that Mi Ying's going to be able to pump out.
Great Despair Stun on top of that Mi Ying. Once again, a defense break being resisted by the Savannah, but a Despair Stun coming out from the Juno. Bomb is getting planted on top of Savannah. I don't think he has to detonate this because the Molly's second skill's already been used.
Yeah, and actually this Sierra is almost down here, but Fran's able to pick it up, but it's under a lot of pressure. This Savannah might be going down soon.
Juno looking for some RNG Despair Stuns. Get that Despair Stun on top of Ada. Hathor looking to dump attack bars to put everybody to sleep here. And there you go, you see it here. Two turn sleeps on everybody, but a resist sleep on top of the Mi Ying. Bomb does detonate, and we have the Savannah getting dropped off the mount. We're gonna see an attack break going out on top of that Mi Ying. That attack break is actually very important to have on Mi Ying.
Yeah, and at the same time, this Savannah is very squishy now. Raigeki's picking up his team well. Tree does not have burst at the moment. That's his problem right now.
Yep, beautiful Despair Stun on top of that Juno, but Juno's going to heal up a little bit because of it, trying to pummel in as much damage on top of that Mi Ying as possible. Hoping for another Despair Stun on Savannah, trying to drop that unit, not receiving it yet.
Yeah, and again, this Savannah does need to crit and proc every single time here because Tree does not have defense break. That's not enough damage. No damage, no burst from no defense break. Hathor does not have skill 3 for a long time.
Yep, does not. Goes with that skill 2 sleep onto the Fran. And we're going to see Mi Ying using that second skill. A little bit of sustain for Raigeki's side of the field as well. A little bit of poke damage happening on top of that CR, but Fran gets that additional turn. Looking for an attack break or to reduce the attack bar. Savannah.
Missing that attack break is huge because if Savannah's able to take a turn, it has a chance to come back.
Oof. Trying to get rid of that Savannah. Savannah's looking real low. Here comes the damage on Savannah, and it's not enough.
Not enough damage, and actually is not does not crit here, does not proc here, so Sierra does take that out. Sierra is tanky enough to survive a couple shots on Martimail. So Raigeki in a really good spot here.
He's in a very good spot, getting those additional turns, trying to get those defense breaks onto Ada. Ada is resisting those defense breaks, but Tree is trying to remove the CR from the field, but Raigeki's got the sustain.
Yeah, at this point here, Raigeki has more damage. He's got a defense break, more heals. Tree doesn't have burst. He doesn't really have much. This game is over. Raigeki's got this one.
I'm not sure I really like the Molly draft in this one. I think he needed something more solid than a Molly pick here. Bomb does try to go out onto the Ada. Ada does resist it.
And I think at the same time, it's that Artemil has not done much this entire match here. Raigeki has so much damage. He's able to take care of this right now. Tree has not been able to take care of anything with no burst here. And it's really showing that that's why Raigeki is going to take this match.
Yep, that's right. So big defense break, finishing off that Molly right there with the Mi Ying. Once again, sustained back onto Ciara. Ciara has these bombs. Raigeki has those defense breaks. He can do away with this Ada. Tree is already thinking about the next match.
Tree should be thinking about the next match and what he should have picked instead, because in this situation, there's nothing he can do. He's taking his time, throwing down that skill 3 delayed promise here, really dragging this out because it's really over. This Juno and this Sierra, it's going to be too much.
That was a lot of damage going on to this Mi Ying, but the Mi Ying still stands tall, gets that defense break onto the Hathor, finishes it off there, and a Juno. And that is going to be it. Raigeki taking round one away from Tree.
What a game by Raigeki. Very well drafted. I really like how he composed that with the Mi Ying. I don't think we've ever seen a Mi Ying yet. And we saw that. And somehow Tree still took the Artemil into it.
Yeah, he still took the Ada. I mean, knowing that CR, he was going to let the CR through, knowing that he was going to let that Mi Ying through, those are bombs, ignoring the defense. That's defense break on top of Ada, trying to limit that damage. Those are all.
Taking out the Mi Ying, Raigeki is taking out the Hathor, does not want to face the Hathor from Tree side because. You know, Tree does have Illyana. It's going to be able to recycle cooldowns a lot. Raigeki goes with that Sierra Fran.
It's Tree once again coming back to Molly. I don't know how I feel about this Molly with Tree. I think Tree should be drafting much more aggressive. I know he can.
I do not like that Molly pick, especially when a Sierra is already on the board. I do like that Illyana a lot. Tree going with that Terra needs to answer the Molong Oberon. But at the same time, Molong, I think Tree's underestimating this combination because Oberon also does have a Ventilate back onto the Molong and onto Sierra for more bombs or Ventilating onto Fran. So it's a lot of auto attack damage. You're going to see some Fran too. So I think Terranese is a little bit weak here. Tree's going to need to do something to disrupt Raigeki's combo.
Yep, I really like Raigeki's draft already. Tree bringing in that Triton, and that might be the unit he's looking for to disrupt the combo.
So if Raigeki were to take out the Terranese and then go with a full sustain comp with maybe an Illusia or something, Tree has no damage. We're going to be in for a long game, and Raigeki has a lot of bursts. I really think that's a weakness in Tree's draft. Right now, he lacks damage. He does have a Ganni. That's a Ganni Triton, so that's a lot of damage missing.
Yep, and we've seen this combination before, Harmony and Molong. Tree, he's got a match ahead of himself here. Bans are out. Ganymede's going to be banned. CR is going to be banned.
Takes out the Ganymede. Makes sense as well. Does not want to face the RNG from procs and a lot of Ventilates here. Tree lacking. Very light on damage. We'll see if Ricky's going to be able to stabilize.
Yep, we'll see it. I mean, I think Ricky's got the draft here, but we're going into round two with Raigeki and Tree. Can we get an upset and Raigeki get the 2-0 on Tree?
Yeah, we know that Tree's going to go straight for this Oberon here. Tree's also going to need to land a lot of those silences from the Triton here, so the key one is to see if he gets it on the Harmonia.
And he gets it on everybody. Silence lands on everyone with the skill 2 of Triton, and Fran looking for an attack break or attack bar pushback on that Illyana.
And that proc is huge because that Fran is able to heal next turn here, and there's nothing that Tree can do about it, so he needs to take out this Oberon right now while that Harmonia is silenced up.
Ghost Force of Living, so that means he's going to be putting a Soul Protection on himself, defense buffing his team, making sure his team is a little tanky.
And I think it might be a little premature to put that Soul Protection on himself because now Ricky can just go after a different unit that is not Terranese, and there's nothing much that Tree can do about it.
Yep, chose to get that glancing on a Terranese, making sure that Wild Blow does not hit hard. We get the cleanse coming up from Molly in an additional turn as well.
Actually, Tree's going to do a lot of damage with this defense buffed Terranese here. So we'll see how well built this Oberon is because that's what Tree's going to be looking for to be able to stabilize and come and win this game here.
Yep, you can tell Tree's trying to really focus down Oberon. That the HP is getting a little low, but we get an additional turn coming out of this Harmonia. Harmonia probably looking to heal up and cleanse that Oberon. Oberon primed and ready.
That is a giant heal because if there was any doubt about that Oberon being able to survive, That doubt is gone. Now this Oberon is also going to be able to nuke a target out, but decides not to do so just yet.
Yeah, chooses not to use any cooldowns at all, just getting that glancing to make sure the Tyranny isn't going to be dealing a lot of damage here. Illyana buffing up and gaining that initial turn as well. Can push up that Windrood. Windrood looking at a wild blow with a defense buff still, and deals massive damage to that Oberon.
Massive damage, but that's all the damage he has right now, and Oberon is not low enough. He's going to throw up skill 3, and we know Oberon's skill 3 is still up, so Raigeki is now going to snipe out a unit, and that's going to be the end of this one.
Yep, you can see Harmonia going for that skill 3, trying to lower that HP as much as possible on top of that Molly. We do have that skill 3 still available on both Molong and the Oberon. We get the Reckless Assault going out on Molly, and Molly's the only form of sustain here.
Yeah, and we see that again. He's trying to get glancing on the Oberon, trying to make sure that he can survive the Oberon, but we're going to see a ton of damage going on to this Molly.
Yep, that is correct. I mean, he has all the skills that he needs. He needs a stun here coming from this Windrood. Can he keep the Oberon back?
I mean, that's a big proc there. Sets him up, gives him another chance to get that stun. Does not.
We're going to see a huge third skill coming out of this Oberon. Is it going to remove the Molly or not? Who is his unit of choice? Chooses to ventilate back onto the Molong.
Raigeki being very patient here, but at the same time, I think maybe not taking into account that Triton does have silence, but did not get silence on Fran, so lucky for him. At the same time, Tree's looking to pump more damage from this Terranese onto Oberon.
Yep, that's right. So we have a skill 2 coming out of Illyana. Maybe pushing up that Triton. No, pushing up itself to get those shields and immunity up,
because he wants to protect Molly and wants to survive again. I think Ricky really should have taken out that Molly, was afraid of glancing, but I think really should have done it because now he needs to survive. And while Harmonia does have skills up, at the same time, as the game goes on, Oberon's going to take more damage.
Yep, that's right. So he does get the cleanse onto the Oberon. Oberon taking another wild blow coming from that Windrood. Illyana boosting up the Windrood here, and Tree still trying to pummel in what damage that he can.
Yeah, and as time goes on, this is going to hurt. This is going to be a lot of damage onto Oberon. Fran does heal for a lot.
Massive heal from Fran right onto that Oberon. We're going to see some glancing not apply to this Oberon.
And we're going to see a double snipe coming out from Raigeki. That's what he's going for right now. The Oberon onto the Terranese into Molong onto the Terranese, and that's his win condition.
And there it is, 41k onto the Windrood. Windrood's going to revive back due to the passive and massive healing coming from that Molly.
But if he chooses to throw a shield on Terranese, I don't know if Molong has enough. I'm not sure if this was the right moment to blow his skills.
Ooh, Triton with the attack bar pushback onto the Molong, but Fran's going to be here to get the attack buffs, healing up his team to full. Is the Reckless Assault going to be enough? Looking for the strip, and hopefully a Violent Proc, and not receiving it. Stun on top of Illyana.
Interesting choice there. I would have thought that he could use Molong's Reckless Assault and then re-ventilate that. Chooses not to do so. So at the same time, Tree knows to just give himself soul protection, and again, we're going to be reset. But that Oberon is a sitting target right now.
It really is. You can see every time this Molly gains a turn, all the HP is going up on his entire team. Getting a nice attack bar pushback on the Illyana. We're going to see a third skill coming out from Harmonia.
And I would like to see this Molong go after this go after Illyana, or even whittle down some health on the Molly and kill the Molly. Something is going to be dropping right now.
And there you have it. He goes right after that Illyana, removing Illyana from the field. Looking very good for Raigeki right now.
Yeah, and there's going to be a lot of damage coming out from Terranese. Terranese does not have the ability to revive for a while.
No, he does not. Goes for a wild blow. Oberon handled it very, very well. Fran fully healing up that Oberon. And Molly gaining some additional turns here, throwing up a nice shield onto Triton.
Wow, and then you're going to see skill 3 coming out from Harmonia, and it's going to do some damage on the Molly, and we're going to see that Molly is the next target of choice.
Ooh, the sweeping waves needed to land on everybody. Did not get the silence on top of Molong. Unit of choice is still going to be the Molly. Gets that defense break as well. Fran trying to pummel in damage. Gets rid of that Molly.
Huge damage.
And there you have it, Raigeki with the 2-0 on Tree. Holy cow.
We did not expect to see that. We've seen